Welcome to our leaders' worship. We wanted to do something fun at the end of the year. So here is our Year 6 timeline. Expect a little bit of cringe and some brilliant acting. We hope you enjoy.
Welcome to Mexico. We explore this unique country from its towering temples and stunning geography to its pulsing rhythms and fun festivals, such as Fiesta de Santa Cecilia, Cinco de Mayo, Las Posadas, and the world-famous Day of the Dead. We learned how they celebrated each festival. We were all very surprised at what we liked.
We discovered the mysterious world of the ancient Maya civilization. The earliest Maya settlement dates around to 1800 BC, over 3800 years ago. At its peak, the Maya population may have reached from 2 million to 10 million. Sadly, by 900 AD, the Maya civilization was gone. Overpopulation, overuse of the land, warfare and drought are believed to be the causes. There are still people alive today who are descendants of the Maya people.
In PE, we played the Maya war game. Watch the boys attempt to play the game. It is very difficult.
Boiling hot slab. Every night, the Lord had a new test for them.
With cunning, they survived the razor, the ice, the fire, and the jaguar. And every night, the lords and the boys played ball. But of course, the Death Lord always cheated. One day, the boys decided to swap the ball with a pumpkin, and when the lords tried to hit it, it exploded all over them. Angered to be outwitted by mere mortals, the lords burned the boys and dumped their ashes into a river. However, this was the boys' plan all along. Magically, they turn into catfish, and then back into boys.
We have magic powers now.
Let's disguise ourselves and pay a visit to the Death Lords.
The Death Lords were excited when they heard of these magical visitors, and they gathered to watch. For his first trip, Hunahpu chopped his brother into pieces. For a second trip, he put him back together. They were amazed and screamed, they chopped up the two most powerful Death Lords, but didn't put them back together. The Death Lords had been defeated. When they were done, the boys rose into the skies to summon the moon, and the rulers of the Mayan were descendants of the Hero Twins, and this gave them the right to rule.
It is estimated that 36,000 of them live today and 7,000 speak the language.
I am a member of the Sami people. We live in Norway, Finland and Sweden. We raise reindeer and move of our homes living in tents. We have close links to Vikings and there is estimated to be 80,000 Sami alive today.
We are the Inuit people from Canada and Greenland. We live close to the coast and live completely off the Sami land for food and clothing. It is estimated that 150,000 Inuit live today and most live in remote places.
We are the Inuit people from Alaska. We live in lightweight structures covered in sealskin mats and hunt for seals, whales and walrus in our kayaks.
It is estimated that 21,000 Inuit live today and 10,000 speak the language. We also live with dogs.
Titanic.
Correct, Titanic. It was a huge 269-meter-long ship that led to 3 football fields. Nowadays, there are bigger ships, but in 1912, it was the biggest ship in the world. The plan was to take passengers from Southampton to New York. However, the unsinkable ship hit an iceberg about 400 miles across the North Atlantic Ocean. More than 1,500 men, women, and children died that night. It has been found that there were many causes for this disaster. We conducted research and debated who was to blame. Please welcome our 4 main suspects and you can make your choice.
I put pressure on Captain Smith to get to New York in record time. I also changed the
design of the ship to increase space in the first class. I also took away many of my clothes to make the decks look less versatile. Am I in the wrong? So, here are our four main suspects. Let's vote. Who votes for Captain Smith? Who votes for the shipbuilder? Who votes for Thomas Andrews? And who votes for British Men? Yeah.
Trenches. Over Christmas of 1914, a remarkable thing happened. In the dank and muddy trenches of the Western Front, soldiers came out of their trenches. It came to be called the Christmas Truce.
We sang songs together, exchanged gifts such as cigarettes and food, we played a game of football. We went to work. It was a perfect Christmas away from home. So, this is the last.
Men waited for a whistle to be blown and then had to go over the top into no man's land. we remember those who died. We went to the cenotaph and joined the two-minute silence and paid our respects to those who fought.
Started in September 1939 and was very different to World War I. World War I was fought using modern artillery, airplanes, ships, tanks. World War I was fought in the trenches and used machine guns and poisonous gas, whereas World War II was fought using modern artillery, airplanes, ships, tanks and submarines. We learnt about Dunkirk, D-Day and Frank and the Holocaust, but we also learnt what it would have been like for us children during the war. As the Nazis were bombing cities across the country. Cities such as London, Cardiff, Edinburgh and Birmingham were heavily bombed. The experiences of the children were varied.
We are having a great experience in Penrhos. We are well cared for and we have lots of food because we grow our own. We are experiencing a
completely
new life in the country.
We have so much farmland to explore. We have seen weird animals, exploring the hills and playing the river. It's not like back home. We miss our parents, but it's fun, so it makes it much easier.
We are not so lucky. We are not well looked after and not fed well. We live on a farm and they make us do work to sunrise to sunset, and we don't even go to school.
They tell us that if we don't work hard enough, they'll strike us.
I can't wait for this war to finish. I want to go back home. I really miss my mom.
Children left the cities. Those that were left had to live through the bombings. This was a typical day at school with the Germans attacking from the air. When the sirens wailed, everyone would leave their homes and get to a shelter. These shelters would prevent people from broken glass and falling through. However, a direct hit would result in death, so it was a very scary experience for everyone. Some Cardiff residents even took shelter in the strong walls of Cardiff Castle. Next time you walk past, you can see where parts of the walls have changed. This is because Cardiff residents have knocked the wall down so people could get in during their raid.
World War II ended in September 1945 and there were celebrations in the streets. Even Princess Elizabeth came out into the crowds.
He was a famous trumpet from Monte Carlo way. He had a book of stuff that no one else could play. He was a tough man at his craft. reveille. He's the boogie woogie bugle horn of Company B. They made him blow a bugle horn.
Thank you. necessary. Blood flows through our bodies in all its vibrant shades of red. As you may have seen on Twitter, we dissected a lamb's heart, we examined the atriums and ventricles, and poked our fingers through the aorta. We pulled straws to see which 15 of us would be offered as guinea pigs, so the other half could use their hearts. Luckily, Mr. McNichol found some hearts. We used them instead. Also, we didn't think you'd be happy with the idea. We will show you how blood travels through the heart.
That we will remember forever. Amen. Thank you for the respect and care that you have given us, and for the friendships that have lasted, and for the ones that have just begun. For the strength and giving us the strength as members of this school, and amazing memories we will cherish forever. Amen.
Thank you for our amazing time in primary school, for the teachers who have respected us and listened to our ideas, and for everyone who has been behind us and supported us. Please give us the strength to push forward on our new path. Amen.
Dear Lord, thank you for giving me the right to a good education, and please help others who aren't as lucky as us. Thank you to everyone in school who has helped us get where we are today, and to our parents who helped us and will continue helping us. Watch over us as we set off on our new journey to high school. Amen.